What kind of enterprise is Cell Biotechnology? To answer this, we will have to go back 8 years. In the early 1990s, Taiwo Wang returned from studying medicine in Europe and was an ambitious young man. Like all young PhDs, Dr. Wang was enthusiastic and full of passion. At the beginning of his career, there was still a gap between China's medical industry and other European and American countries. Dr. Wang made the best use of what he had learned over the years and established the Shandong Red Cross Intervention Hospital. By 2003, the emerging field of clinical stem cell technology had developed significantly, and the Shandong Red Cross Intervention Hospital became the first specialized stem cell hospital in China. After 2 years of clinical experience in stem cell, Dr. Wang realized that the core technology should be within his control. So, in 2005, he created the Shandong New Institute of Integrated Traditional Chinese and Western Medicine. This allowed him to formally enter the field of stem cell research. Entrepreneurship is difficult, and scientific research is equally demanding. The combination of these two disciplines is even more challenging. Fortunately, a group of like-minded friends were willing to give up high-paying jobs in order to make breakthroughs in this uncharted territory for China. Cell biotechnology has attracted many talented collaborators from well-known research institutions and famous universities, such as Peking University, Shandong University, and the Chinese Academy of Sciences. As far away as the United States, Cell Biotechnology has collaborated with University of Pennsylvania, Stanford University, and other prestigious institutions. Many veteran employees fondly recall the early years of the company, noting, "At that time, we are all so full of passion and ambition." The effort has certainly paid off. As research for the autologous stem cell, ASEL, was successful in 2010. This technology is world-leading. Today, it represents the most advanced autologous embryonic stem cell technology in the industry. The magnitude of change in this small biotechnology company has been immense. In 2012, Cell Biotechnology Co. Ltd. was officially established in Songshan Lake. This was the first adult stem cell bank in China and represented the transition from medical to civilian use. From 2012 to 2020, Cell Biotechnology grew rapidly, setting up subsidiaries in Shenzhen, Dongguan, Guangzhou, Qingdao, Jinan, Guiyang, Chengdu, Shenzhou, Weifang, Suzhou, Foshan, Xiamen, Singapore, Indonesia, California, New York, Sydney, Melbourne, Toronto, Frankfurt, and more. In 2018, Cell Biotechnology hosted an international research symposium in Beijing, China, which included speakers such as Nobel laureate and Stanford professor Dr. Thomas Sudhoff, University of Toronto professor Dr. Yakov Ben-David, Canada's Royal Academy of Sciences professor Yu Tian Wang, as well as other members of the Royal Canadian Academy of Sciences, and other top international experts who joined the scientific research team. In 2018, Cell Biotechnology was one of the 33 representatives at the signing conference for the major investment and promotion projects in Shenzhen. Cell Biotechnology was the only high-tech biotechnology enterprise with the focus in stem cell technology. Since then, Cell Biotechnology has been strongly recommended by the Shenzhen Municipal Party, Secretary Wei Zongwang, Mayor Rugai Chen, Vice Mayor Zimin Gao, Vice Mayor Li Xingwang, and other prominent leaders. Years of hard work is finally being recognized by both academia and government. The COVID-19 pandemic caused the world to stop in 2020, but Cell Biotechnology's scientific research continues to move forward. Breakthroughs have been made in the field of neonatal stem cells, Immunity Cells, Autologous Precision Cells, and JF Series Technology. In particular, the successful research and development of a T10 tumor vaccine has been developed, which is not only accurate, fast, and safe, but also expends 20 to 30 billion cells, making unprecedented breakthroughs in the field of cell immunology. Today, Cell Biotechnology partners with many prestigious institutions, both domestic and foreign. These include the University of Pennsylvania, Harvard University, the University of Southern California, Stanford University, Seoul, South Korea University, Southern Medical University, Guangdong University of Medical Sciences, Peking University, Shenzhen Hospital, Shilu Hospital, Hospital of Foshan City, Foshan Indonesia Sarabaya Hospital, Maternity and Children's Healthcare Centers, Shanghai Oriental Hospital, Boao Evergrande International Hospital, and many more. Looking back on the 8th anniversary of Cell Biotechnology, it is like a giant ship of human biotechnology. The joint efforts of our scientific research team and staff are proving to be successful. Cell Biotechnology is striving toward the highest goals of human regenerative medicine and are advancing to a younger, healthier future. Science and technology guard life, and Cell Biotechnology will continue to redefine what is possible for the future.